This work is jointly with my colleagues from the University of Talca, which really have done all the work. Roberto Jara Rojas was supposed to be here and deliver this, but we have done a few iterations about this through email, so I'll do what I can. The title is long and it's much more ambitious than what we really have been able to accomplish to date. I want to make a point that Hildegard had this beautiful data set, 12,000 observations, 10 years of data. In Chile, we don't have data, you know? I think Argentina is richer in data than we are. So anytime you want to do something, you got to get out there, you got to get some money, and you got to collect the data. So you got to do surveys, and we're always doing surveys. So I want to give you a very brief thing. This is totally half-baked, at best half-baked. But I'll give you an idea of what it is that we want to do, and maybe I'll try to connect it this time with some of the presentation earlier from Dr. Genari. So introduction, methodology, results, not really, and then what we really want to do in terms of future work. So some of you know where Chile is. Some of you have been there. I think all of you know where it is. Some of you have had the good fortune of being there at different conferences and so forth. And if I might say, we have here Valparaíso, okay? And the Valle de Casablanca Valley, which is a relatively new valley. When I was a kid, we used to go always to the coast. There was no grapes. Now it's high quality. And the valleys between Valparaíso, next to it is a beautiful city, Viña del Mar, and then Santiago, where the airport is. So we're thinking about having a joint effort, Universidad de Talca, Chile, Universidad de Cuyo, Mendoza, to maybe do this in 21, that's right. So think about it. You know, it hasn't been decided. I don't know who's going to decide, but we're talking about it. The Chilean government actually has made an overture to Carl about support, so we need to figure out what that really is about. But what we see here is that land in grapes in Chile has gone up very quickly, and the valleys where we had some previous meetings in Talca is one of the, which is the Maule Valley, is the major valley. Prices, you know, my family, we have a small vineyard and we produce grapes, Carmenere and Cabernet Sauvignon, that we sell to Concha y Toro, and I can tell you that this year we closed it, no more. The prices are extremely low, and these are nominal prices. They have been stable over time, and then you have labor costs and everything else. You just can't make it on 150 pesos a kilo, which is 33, 40 cents of a dollar for a kilogram that they pay you. So this is there's a real pressure, particularly on the small ones and medium-sized grape producers, my interest is grape producers, to survive. And along with that, we have this thing that we've talked so much about, climate change. And we got to make sure we make the distinction between climate and weather. I think a couple of papers has been made, but sometimes it's confused. But in any ways, we are expecting some major declines in precipitation. And Chile's mountains, a big mountain, it rains down in the valleys, in the Central Valley, which is the main valley, snows up, it packs, and then we have natural flow of water over the season, and we have all these reservoirs. So it's a nice system, provided that it rains, and provided that the snowpack is of quality. So this has become an increasing concern, and we have to fight with the hydroelectric companies and all this stuff. And of course, temperatures are supposed to go up quite dramatically. We already have seen how the frontier for grapes has moved south. It's moving continuously south, which is cooler, which gets more rain historically. So we got to worry about technology adoption. One of the things that we are really concerned about is irrigation. If you see the way irrigation is done in much of Chilean agriculture, it's like flood. And you not only flood the field, you flood the roads, you flood anything that gets on the way. So there's a lot of waste of water. Technical assistance needs to be developed for this, and this idea of social capital that some of my colleagues are really interested in how this works and how can that increase productivity. So the data comes from two valleys, Maule and O'Higgins. Maule is the largest in terms of production. That's where Talca is. O'Higgins is the most historical and famous valley through many, many years since the time of the Spanish. And, the regions, okay? And then we have the Colchagua, Curicó, and Maule Valley. So two regions, three valleys. We have surveys for 452 farmers. I think this was 2015 was collected. And because we have some repeated varieties, we have more than one observation per farm. So we try to exploit that, applying basically panel data models to repeated, what we have called repeated cross-sections. Reviewers don't like that, but you can call it, if you have several plots and you have blood level data, then you have sort of a panel on space rather than time. So to do that, to exploit that, in this paper, we use a true random effects, which is a panel data model introduced by Bill Green in 2005. And basically, it's a Cobb-Douglas production function. You have output, you have inputs, and then we have three error terms. One captures farm-level heterogeneity, this WI or omega I, whatever. Then we have VIJ, which is a two-sided error that we have lived with all our lives. And then the UIJ is a farm-specific, plot-specific term, which is one-sided and provides the idea of technical efficiency, which is really a measure of management, the way we have seen this over the last 50 years, although the discipline is a little sloppy about that. So I can't tell you how water was put in terms of volumetric, but there was a lot of effort in this data to get volume of water. So we can then concentrate on what we do here very briefly, is get the shadow value of water, right? Look at the literature, it is irrigate, don't irrigate. Share irrigated, share non-irrigated. Volumetric is fantastic. I know in Australia, everything is pressurized, so Australia probably, that's my understanding, probably has the best volumetric measures of water applied in agriculture. We don't do it that way, so we developed that. So we have the data here, very conventional land labor, purchase inputs and water. Now, one of the things, and the reviewers of a different paper, and I see some of the papers here, I've been tempted to ask the question, should one have land in a plantation production function, like in grapes? So the paper from Argentina doesn't have land, and you get an elasticity for water that was 0.46 or something. We put land in here, so it really loads on land. So you will see the elasticity is very high for land, and right here, and from water, it's very low. And that's an issue that is not clear. I mean, it's clear to me from theory what the production function should have, but when you send things out to reviewers, they have different opinions, all right? So we have specified a model, very traditional. This is from the Batiste and Coeli 1995 type, so we have inefficiency effects. We're trying to capture some things that I will not really discuss very much, but this is the inefficiency effects. We do pick up some nice things, like education is positive on efficiency. In the model, comes negative because it's inefficiency, but it's positive on efficiency. Older farmers are less efficient, and this idea, they have the social capital. I have no idea how they have defined this, a couple measures. There is some evidence of positive effects on productivity, on the efficiency side of productivity of social capital. So now the core of what we have done up to now is, okay, so we estimated this model. And I want to know what is the shadow value of water. We have water rights that are allocated separately from land. You can rent, but we have no idea what are the rental rates on an annual time frame for your water. All right, so here we, in a very traditional way, so being a Cobb-Douglas, very simple, we get an average shadow value of 0.52, and I have no idea if this makes any sense in terms of what the market will be per cubic meter. The reference price that we have is for one point, which is Nanero Convento Viejo, 1 minute. Okay, perfect. And it's 0.4. So in essence, on average here, economically, they should be using more water. Now, we have not exploited the fact that we have some people that use gravity irrigation and others that use technical irrigation. So there's lots to exploit on this data set. The value of the water applied per hectare on average for all these 1,000 plus observations is $405 per hectare valued at the shadow value. OK, Okay, so a little bit lower if we use the reference price. Okay, since we have 1 minute, I think it's going to be perfect. I have some idea about technical efficiency and all of this. Now, just to come back to the paper in Argentina, the measures that we have here, when you look at technical efficiency from production functions, it's output oriented. Observed output over efficient output. So it's a number less than one. If you want to get into individual inputs, like we want to do at some point to get the efficiency of irrigation, it's a whole different thing. And these are the sort of so-called non-radial measures that have been developed and we have applied and published recently on irrigation water. You can look for any input. So what do we want to do when we grow up? What am I going to tell my team in a couple of weeks when I'm in Chile to do? Well, we'll decide jointly. This is very preliminary. First, there's a lot to be done in the refinement of the estimation procedure. We have been using random parameter models, which work really nice and have some very nice advantages that we need to look at this. And then we really want to hone in on this water use efficiency idea. And this model comes from Reinhardt, Lobel, and Sitchin in 1999, Karigiannis, Sublekas in 2003, and we have sort of revived this with a different estimation procedure to be able then to get non-radial. So if you think of an isoquant, you think the efficient output, the inefficient output for a given firm, and then you look at how much water was used. Well, was it too much? You can calculate that for any input. So you can calculate input specific, but non-radially. So that's something we want to do. And then there's a great deal of heterogeneity that needs to be exploited and see. I mean, if I'm interested in shadow value of water, it varies by valley, it varies by region, it varies by farm size, but type of grape and so forth. So there's lots to be said here about the fundamental question, are we using too much water? Can we save water by doing better irrigation? And that is a critical question in my little country of Chile. Thank you.